Now, allow me to answer this question. Which fruit does not raise blood sugar? I received this question many times. Now, the answer to this question is all fruit raise blood sugar. Those in the internet that they just keep on saying, eat this, eat that, and they just talking nonsense, sorry about this word. And they advise us to take some apple, some orange. No, this is based on long scientific research since I stopped taking my diabetes medication in 2017 and my own experience with each fruit that I'm gonna mention. So what to eat as a diabetic or a person with type 2 diabetes? Look for two things. The first thing is the glycemic index, which is how fast your blood sugar, that fruit or the sugar in that fruit and the carbs will go into your bloodstream. And look for the glycemic load, which is the sugar and the carbs in that fruit. They say should be above 70. I say no. If any fruit, any food above 65, do not take it as a diabetes or someone having diabetes. Middle 50 to 65, low is 50. This is the glycemic index. The higher, the worse. Sugar and carbs. Everybody saying above 20 grams of sugar. That's high. I say no, above 16 is high. Medium 10 to 15 and low is 10 or below. According to so many authorities and bodies, the allowed amount of glucose that a person should take is 50 grams every 24 hours. I say no, the best for you as a person is to take around 30, less than 30 is better. That's including glucose, fructose, lactose, sucrose, and all these kind of sugar. This is what allowed. Now, what not to eat to avoid and not to make it as a daily habit? Because I have heard in many, many places that one fruit dish a day keeps the diabetes away. No, this is not right and not true. Now, the glycemic load is more important than the glycemic index. If the glycemic index is low and the amount of sugar and carbs in 100 gram is high, we should not take this fruit. The first thing you should avoid, dates of any kind. Why? Because half of it is sugar. We are talking here about 100 grams. Half of it is sugar. And there is around 39 grams of carbs. This is a no-no for anyone with diabetes, type 1 or type 2. It's a no-no. It will raise your blood sugar, spike it so high. And in the same time, spike your insulin level, which is also harmful for our body. Watermelon. Watermelon is not allowed completely. Why? Glycemic index is 87. It's worse than bread, rice, and all this kind of stuff. And it contains 14 grams of sugar and 11 grams of carbs. Not allowed. It's no, no. The pineapple, it contains 13 grams of sugar and 13 grams of carbs. It will spike your blood sugar sky high, rocket sky very fast. And mango. Yes, they said the glycemic index is around 50 to 60, but it has 24 grams of sugar and 24 grams of carbs. And I don't believe when people come and say the sugar is the same like the carbs. No, the carbs is inside the fruit. However, when we eat it, we know how sugary it is and how sweet it is. Pomelo. I used to eat this fruit. However, I discovered that the glycemic index is quite high and it contains 7 grams of sugar and 10 grams of carbs. Squash, not allowed. Very high glycemic index, high in sugar and high in carbs. So it's not allowed. This is an enemy. Banana. And you try. Just take two bananas. And if your sugar level, let's say 90, 95, take two bananas. And after half an hour, you check your sugar. You will find it 165 and above. And after 1 hour, you will find it are almost 200. It contains 13 grams of sugar and 23 grams of carbs. So it's not allowed. Grapes. a glycemic index in the okay level. However, it contains 18 grams of sugar and 17 grams of carbs. Oranges, not allowed. 10 grams of sugar, 13 grams of carbs, and that make a total of 5 spoons of table sugar in your bloodstream just by eating 100 grams of orange. Plums, not allowed. 10 grams of sugar, 11 grams of carbs. And the glycemic index, even though it's low, however, we should avoid it. I'm not saying that you cut it completely. Don't make it as a habit. Every day I have to take fruit. Make it as occasionally as possible. Make it like a birthday cake. You don't take birthday cake every day. Not necessarily to take every day. Since you have diabetes problems and you are diabetic, type 1 or type 2. Apple, the red apple, 100 grams of apple contains 19 grams of sugar, 4 spoons of table sugar, and 16 grams of carb. It's a no-no. Persimmon is really high in sugar and very high in carbs. So it's a no-no for us. Pomegranate, the glycemic index is okay. However, look at the amount of sugar and carbs in this fruit. Kiwi, so many people I've seen on YouTube advising people to have kiwi every day. No, it has 10 grams of sugar and 15 grams of carbs, which will spike your blood sugar very fast. Papaya is not allowed because it contains sugar and carbs, about 28 grams of sugar and carbs. Quince also very high in sugar, 13 grams of sugar and 14 grams of carbs. Dragon fruit, you should be away from it, even though it's very beneficial, healthy, and a lot of vitamins and so on. However, the sugar and the carb are really high, and we should avoid all of them. Lychee or lychee, which is Asian fruit, 16 grams of sugar in each 100 grams, 16 grams of sugar and 17 grams of carbs. We should not eat it, and we should avoid it. Longan or cat's eye, the glycemic index is so high, and it contains 20 grams of sugar and 18 grams of carbs, which is a no to go. Mangosteen, 58 glycemic index, 28 grams of sugar, 35 grams of carbs. This fruit is not allowed to enter hotels, hospitals, clinics. Why? Wherever this thing or this fruit comes, ants will fill the floor, will fill everywhere because it's so sweet and ants love it. Rambutan, this is also Asian fruit, 9 grams of sugar and 21 grams of carbs, make a total of 30 because the carbs will turn into sugar. And the total 30 means you are having 6 teaspoons of sugar in your bloodstream. Durian, Asian fruit, nice, good to eat. However, high in carbs and high in sugar. Jackfruit is also high in sugar and high in carbs. 100 grams of both will give us around 60 grams of sugar and carbs together. Why you should not eat these fruits? This is my experience with all these kinds, because I used to eat and I test after eating each kind of fruit. Why you should not eat them? I tell you why. If you are looking forward to lose weight, if you are suffering from type 2 diabetes, if you want to correct your shape, like what happened with me, this is how I look in 2017, 2016, and this is how I look now. I just thrown all my medications, type 2 diabetes medication, 4 medication I used to take. I throw them all since that day after I heard some doctors in the internet, and I follow their advice, and I start studying anything related to type 2 diabetes. Now, does our body need fruit? Of course. They are the best food on earth, on this planet. They are full of vitamins, minerals. They are antioxidants. They are really healthy. However, when we are diabetes, we have to understand that our body does not need fructose, does not use it. It has to go through the liver first to be turned into glucose, then it will go to our bloodstream as energy. we have to be extra careful with fructose. We have to calculate everything because it will go straight from our mouth. And the pancreas, by the way, does not understand this is fructose, this is this and that. Insulin level will go up straight away. Our body is smart. The moment we eat this fructose, the pancreas will give orders to, the brain will give order to the pancreas to give what? To give insulin. That's number one. Number two, this fructose will go all to the liver. And when the liver has too much work to do, it will make it easier job for her, for the liver to transfer this fructose into fat rather than turn it into glucose. But are we careful with our fructose? I think no. Why? Because this is our breakfast, pancakes, etc., etc. This is our snack after breakfast, before lunch. This is our appetizers before lunch. This is our lunch, which is big problem. When you mix proteins, etc., and carbohydrates, it's a big issue. And this is with or after lunch. We like to have these soda drinks, etc., etc., with lunch or after lunch. And so, like what other people say, eat fruit every day after food, which is good for you, and it will eliminate the risk of having type 2 diabetes. No, it's not true at all. And we have a problem. While we're eating, we call the house or our homes and ask what's for dinner. This is not right. And at night, when we are watching TV, we will start snacking and taking some popcorns or chips or whatever we have. Then we start asking ourselves, why am I too fat? Why am I too fat? Why too much fat in my body everywhere? This is because of our eating habits. Should you follow my advice? It's up to you, up to you. And I'm telling you, do not follow anybody blindly. Dr. Ali came and say, eat this fruit. Don't listen to him. Just try it yourself. Have the testing machine, the blood test machine like this one. I have two machines. So eat and test. See, does it affect you or not? Be your own doctor. Get the testing kit and test your blood by yourself after eating whatever you want. Try every fruit that, even the one I mentioned, I'm asking you not to eat. Try it by yourself. Try it by yourself. Maybe it affects me and it does not affect you. Just follow what your machine and your body tells you. And then check. As long as you are in the green range, you are fine. If you are not, stop eating these things. But don't go and eat this amount from fruit and come and say, I did not control my blood level or my blood sugar level. I could not lose weight. No. Be your own doctor and just eat moderately, slowly, and not necessarily every day. As I said, as a birthday cake, and do not eat these fruit if you have diabetes. And please share this if you find it useful. Share it with everybody you care about. Anyone who has type 2 diabetes, anyone with high blood pressure, or anyone that you know he is or she is obese. Thank you so much for watching. And I wish I meet you in another video. Thank you again.